हेलो दिए, सो वेलकम यू ऑल अगेन टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड स्टैटिस्टिक्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वन मोर कंटिन्यूस रैंडम वेरिएबल और कंटिन्यूस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन विच इज़ कॉल्ड योर नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। ओके, सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस द यूनिफॉर्म एंड एक्सपोनेंशियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड सॉल्व अ फ्यू प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विद द नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। वेन अ कंटिन्यूस रैंडम वेरिएबल इज सेड टू बी नॉर्मल। ओके, ओके, सो अ कंटिन्यूस रैंडम वेरिएबल एक्स इज सेड टू बी नॉर्मल वेरिएट विथ, जनरली इट इज डिफाइंड विथ टू पैरामीटर्स, विथ टू पैरामीटर्स म्यू विच इज योर मीन, ओके, एंड द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन एज द सिग्मा। ओके, स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन इफ द प्रोबेबिलिटी डेंसिटी फंक्शन, because this is a continuous distribution, it needs the probability density function or PDF. okay, so PDF is given as small f, so which is your 1 by sigma and square root of 2 pi e to the power minus 1 by 2 x minus mu divided by sigma squared, okay, and your x lying between negative infinity to positive infinity. Okay, so though this is a limiting form of binomial distribution, this is beyond the scope because it is not so useful for you to find the probability in the normal distribution. Okay, so this is a limiting form of binomial distribution, you just remember this. Right, so this is the first part. So now what I can see from the property of the PDF, I can take the integral from your negative infinity to positive infinity for the given random variable, given PDF of this normal distribution, and I will integrate with respect to x, I am supposed to get unity. Okay, so generally the form of this distribution is, if this is the real line we have, so this is represented like this. Okay, so which is your Bell shift. Okay, so that means what I can say, the third part is that, and it has the, this function will attain its maximum at the mean or the mean mu. Okay, so first of all it is Bell shift. Okay, and is symmetric about the mean. Okay, that means x equals to mu, right? So now what happened, this is also considered as the median, and definitely more because the function is attaining its maximum. Okay, so what do I mean, it's symmetric about this, that means whatever area you have here mu to infinity, okay, that means this one, it's same as the area from your negative infinity to mu. Okay, so the property here, what I can say, the fourth one is that the mean, median and mode coincide in this distribution. You just remember this fact because in some years the question has come. Okay, in this distribution. So what do I mean by this? If I integrate the PDF from negative infinity to mu, will be same as the mu to positive infinity. Okay, will be 1 by 2, or I can say this is the coverage of 50% of the entire area. So this will cover 50% of the entire area of the entire distribution, right? So as it is symmetric about the mean, the one more fact is that I have found the conclusion is that the PDF is even, okay? The PDF is an even function. Right? So what do I mean? If I integrate, rather than integrating this function from negative infinity to infinity, I can say that this is 2 times the area from here, 0 mu to mu to infinity. Okay? So the next fact is that while finding the probability in this normal variate, we are not using this one, rather we are going for the standard normal variate, right? So मेरा कहने का मतलब यह है कि हमें अगर probability इसमें निकालनी है normal variate में, in this normal distribution, हमें इस form में नहीं निकालते हैं, rather हम लोग क्या करते हैं, we are going to the standard normal variate by a transformation. Okay, so what is the transformation? We have to transform the variate to the standard normal variate by taking x minus mu by sigma as another variable. Okay, so let me just find you the standard normal variate. Standard normal. So what do I mean? So here you introduce another variable. Introduce a variable as your z equals to x minus mu by sigma. So what happened? This z will follow, the z is assumed as now standard normal variate. Standard normal variate with its mean as 0 or 0 mean, and the standard deviation in short I am writing it as SD as 1. Okay, so that means for a standard normal variate its mean is 0 and the standard deviation is unity, right? Then what I can say, the PDF here or the probability density function is given as small f, sorry, not f, I'll consider another function, let us say phi as your 1 by square root of 2 pi, okay, and e to the power minus z squared by 2, right, and your z is lying between negative infinity to infinity, right? So now let us check the transformation here from x to, so the second property I'll write here definitely. If I just consider the integral of this function or the PDF probability density function from negative infinity to infinity, definitely I'll get 1. Okay. So now in the entire real line, what are the correspondence of the normal variate with the standard normal variate? So one more thing, what we have done here, I'll show you. Okay. So that means x, which is given as your normal variate with your mu as the mean and the standard deviation as this, will be transformed to your z, that means which is a standard normal variate with mean as 0 and the standard deviation as 1 or the variance as 1 also I can assume. Okay, so this is the transformation we are using. So this is a normal variate or the given normal variate, and we are going to the standard normal variate. Now let's go for the probabilities. Okay, so let us say this is our real line we have, and we are considering this as the sorry, let me just wait. Let us say this is your this is just the exaggerated graph, I'll say. Okay, so let us say this is the mean of the normal variate x. Okay, so here I'll correspond, let us say your x, and the second line I'll take the corresponding points of your standard normal variate. Let us say this is the mu, where the normal variate is attaining its maximum. Okay, now this mean is 0 in case of your standard normal variate. Okay, So let me change the ink. This is different. Okay. So from mu plus mu minus sigma to mu plus sigma, what is the probability for the given random given normal variate? Okay. So what I mean, I'll try to find this area. Okay. Though this is not seeming to be symmetric, but you consider it as symmetric. Okay. So this is the mean is 0 for the standard normal variate, whereas this point is negative 1 and this is 1. If you substitute in place of x as this 2, you will get your negative 1 and positive 1. So the next area is from your mu minus 2 sigma to your mu plus 2 sigma, or mu plus 2 times the standard deviation. So it will be your negative 2 to 2. And similarly, the last one is your, let us say, your mu minus 3 sigma to mu plus 3 sigma. Okay, so these are a bit important, that's why I'm taking the probabilities. Okay, so different probabilities you will get. Okay, that means what is the area covered by these three intervals. Okay, so this is from negative 3 to 3. Okay, so let's find one by one. So the very first is, let us say, your probability that your x lying between mu minus sigma to mu plus sigma, mu minus sigma to your mu plus sigma. So it is same as the probability that your z lying between this is z, negative 1 to positive 1. Okay, as we know that whichever the variate we are taking, whether this is normal or the standard normal, this is symmetric, right, with respect to mean as mu, or for the standard normal variate with respect to 0. So this will be what, 2 times the probability from 0 to 1. Okay, so let me go for the next phase to show you the standard, the area under the standard normal variate, because in open resources you won't find the area under the any of the given normal variate. So that's why what you do, you take the transformation to the standard normal variate and you will get the tabulation for that, and you can make use of that. Okay, so this is the area under the standard normal curve. So what you'll do, see, so from 0 to 1 we are trying to find the area, so that's why you start with the column as 0 and you go up to 1. Okay, so this is the area under the standard normal curve, right? So here I'll write 2 times the area is your 0.3413, which is your 0.6826. okay, so that means this area is your 68.26% of the entire normal distribution, okay, or the entire area, right? So now if I'll go for the second part, that means your mu minus 2 sigma to mu plus 2 sigma, I'll go for the next phase for the solution, okay, because it will be more convenient. So from the probability that x lying between mu minus 2 sigma to mu plus 2 sigma, okay, so this is the equality I have taken here. So this is same as the probability that the z lying between 0 minus 2 to 2, that means this is your 2, is your 0.4772, okay, which is your 2 times the probability that z lying between 0 to 2. Okay, so this is 2 times 0.4772, which is definitely point here, this is 4 again, then you have 5 and 9. Okay, so that means from negative 2 to 2 for the standard normal variate, it will cover your 95.44% of the entire area. Third one is the probability that x lying between mu minus 3 sigma to mu plus 3 sigma, okay, or the 3 times the standard deviation. So this is your probability that the z lying between minus 3 to 3, okay, which is 2 times the probability that z lying between 0 to 3, which is your this one, right, 0 to 3, 4987.4987, which is what, let us find, this is 4, 6, 7 and 99. Okay, so that means from negative 3 to 3, it is almost considering the entire area, right, 99.74% of the area. Okay, So basically, this information will be provided to you if any of such question will come. Okay. So what you'll do for a given normal variate, you have to transform this to the standard normal variate, and you find the probability using this area under the standard normal curve. Okay. So if possible, this curve will this will be given in the lecture. Okay. While the premiere will be done. So this is the first question I have assumed. X is normally distributed with mean as 12 and the standard deviation is 4. Okay. So for the solution, you start with X as a normal variate with 12 as mean, and you start with the mean and the variance as, sorry, the standard deviation as 4. Okay. Now find out the probability of the following. So first of all, what I have told you, you go for the standard normal variate. That means let X, sorry, Z, capital Z, as your X minus mean divided by your standard deviation. Okay, so now you are done with this, and this is a normal variate with your mean as 0 and the standard deviation as 1, right? So for the first bit, what you'll do, the probability that X is greater than or equals to 20 is what the probability that X minus 12 by 4, let me take the operation, okay, for the transformation, and 20 minus 12 divided by 4, right? So this will be what? The probability that Z is greater than or equals to 2, right? So which is, I'll show you that curve, okay? Z greater than or equals to 2, that means the value of Z is greater than this 2, okay? It is asking you for this one, 2 to positive infinity, okay? So which is the better way to find the solution is that, let us go for the half of the area from mu to infinity, 0.5, minus the area from 0 to 2, this area, okay? So let me just solve this problem. So here you'll get your 0.5 minus the probability that the Z lying between 0 to 2, right? So this is Z, okay? So which is your 0.5 minus 0.4772. So few times you just remember this fact, point from 0 to 1 is 0.3413, point from 0 to 2 is 0.4772, okay? So you'll get your 0.0228, okay? Similarly, this will be done because this is the complementary event of this one, and the third one here, okay, let me just write, the probability that X is less than or equals to 20 is 1 minus 0.0228, so you'll get your 0.9772, okay? And the third one is that probability of 0 X lying between 0 to 12, that means this is your probability that I'm directly considering this Z is less than or equals to 0, which is same as the probability that Z lying between 0 to 3, okay? So 0 to 3 is 0.4987, probably we have got this 0.4987, okay? So you are done with this. You try to solve the second example, and let's go for the previous year example questions, okay? So in civil engineering in 2014, it came this one, okay? So if X is a continuous real value random variable defined over the interval from, this should not be the negative, from negative infinity to positive infinity, and its occurrence is defined by the density function given as this one, okay? So this is clearly seem to be your what? Normal variate, okay? 1 by square root of 2 pi b e to the power negative 1 by 2 x minus a by b whole squared, okay? Where a and b are the statistical attributes of the random variable x, okay? So here a x minus mu, that means your a is the mean, okay? So here it is clearly seen that mean is a for your for the random variable x, okay? The value of the integral from negative infinity to a for this one is what? Okay, so this is the PDF we have for the normal variate from negative infinity to a. Will cover the 50% of the area, right? So I'll show you. See, so from negative infinity to mu, okay, so here I have told you that from negative infinity to mu will cover the 50% of the entire area, okay? So that's why here you write the 0.5, okay, right? So this came in ECE for the 2014. So let X be a zero mean unit variance Gaussian random variable. So one thing you just remember, this Gaussian means your normal random variable, okay, or the normal variate, right? So x is a normal variate with your mean as 0, and this is a standard normal variate basically, okay. So we know that the corresponding probability mass function is your 1 by square root of 2 pi and e to the power minus x squared by 2, okay, and x lying between negative infinity to infinity. In the entire real line, the standard normal variable is given, okay, or is defined. So now it is asking you to find the expectation of mod of x, okay. So we know that this is your integration from negative infinity to infinity, because this is a continuous random variable, okay. So mod x and the f of x, the given PDF we have, or the obtained PDF we have. So one more thing, see, so this function is even because this is a modulus function, and I have told you that this is also even because this is symmetric about the mean 0, okay. So the product of two even function is even. So what I will do, I can write it as 2 times 0 to infinity x and the given PDF we have, or the obtained PDF, sorry, 1 by square root of 2 pi and e to the power minus x squared by 2 and the integration with respect to x, okay. So the next one is that I'll take square root of 2 pi out of this integration, so I'll get your square root of 2 by pi, and I'll take a substitution for your x squared by 2. So let your t be your x squared by 2, so I'll get dt, or the, if I'll integrate, sorry, differentiate with respect to x, so I'll get your x dx, okay. So in place of x dx, I'll substitute your dt and e to the power minus t dt from your 0 to infinity, okay. So this is the simplest integration. You will get 2 by square pi and your minus e to the power minus t from 0 to infinity, right? So if I here you have a negative, so you substitute the lower limit first. So square root of 2 pi 1 minus, for the upper limit it will be 0, so you will get your square root of 2 by pi, okay. So let me get the solution here. So square root of 2 by pi is your 0.798, okay. So this is your 0.798. So up to 3 decimal place of accuracy I have taken here, right. The next is the annual precipitation data of a city is normally distributed, okay. So what I'll do, I'll take the capital X as the annual precipitation data. Data of a city, okay, is normally distributed with the mean as mean and standard deviation 1000 and 200, okay, 1200. So this is a normal variate we have. The probability that the annual precipitation will be more than 1200. That means what is the probability that x is greater than 1200? Okay. So what I can write here, that your probability that z is greater than, you just take the transfer or the convert the variable or transform the variable, transform to your standard normal variate. That means your 1200 minus 1000 mean divided by the standard deviation. Okay. So this is your probability that z is greater than 1. Okay. So greater than 1, it cannot be 50% or 75% or 100%. From the logic itself, you can say this is less than 50%. Okay. Otherwise, you can go for your 0.5 minus probability that z lying between 0 to 1. Okay. So 0 to 1, we know that this is your 0.3413. So you will automatically get here 7, then your 8, then your 5 and 1, okay, 0.1587. So this is your 15.87% of the entire area, okay. So now the so this is the question came in 2017. So the number of parameters in the univariate exponential and the Gaussian distribution, okay. So for the exponential distribution, we need only one parameter, which is the lambda, and 1 by lambda, or the reciprocal of this parameter, is your mean of the exponential distribution. And here you do need two parameters, which is your mu and the standard deviation, okay. So that's why the solution will be 1 and 2, okay. So these are a few questions I have found. You try to find as many questions you can and solve and practice as much you can. And thank you very much. for your patients. Okay, so in next class we may move to the correlation or the regression. Let us see, because these are there in a few branches, like if the civil engineering and the ECE. Okay, so thank you very much once again, and wish you all the luck.